Good evening. Welcome live to the sanctuary of Encounter Church. And how about these two guys behind me?
Good evening, everybody.
Do they have my back or what? Yes, they do. They have my back physically, emotionally, spiritually, in every which way.
Yep, they do. Amen.
And we thank the Lord for them. And we thank the Lord for you. Trust you're doing well tonight.
Yes.
And if you're not doing well, you're gonna by the time tonight is over, you will be able to say, "It is well with my soul."
Amen.
I'll say it again. By the time tonight is over, you will be able to say, "It is well with my." It is well. It is well with my soul. You guys know that song?
Yes.
It is well with my soul. It is well. It is well with my soul. Let's sing it again. It is well with my soul. It is well, it is well with my soul. And we claim that tonight,
yes,
in the mighty name of,
yes,
the Lord Jesus for you. I mean that.
Yes.
We're not just singing that to sing that. You know, when David was discouraged, you ever get discouraged? Hello? If you ever get discouraged, tonight's a good time to tune in if you need to be encouraged. But when David got discouraged, you know what he would do? He would what?
Encourage himself in the Lord.
He would encourage himself in the Lord, but how?
Singing. Music.
Singing.
Minstrel.
When David was discouraged, he would encourage himself in the Lord. You know, you can't always count on people encouraging you. You can't always count on that. But you can count on your obedience. I can count on my obedience to the Lord and encouraging myself.
Amen.
In the Lord.
Amen.
I don't want to just encourage myself. I want to encourage myself in the Lord. And that's what David did. That's what made him a man after God's own heart. That's what made him a mighty, mighty warrior. He was able to encourage himself in the Lord. You know, he won all these battles. And sometimes he felt lonelier than lonely. Lonelier than lonely. He was one of the loneliest men of God. David was one of the most loneliest. Read the book of Psalms. I know you do. But I know sometimes we just pick our favorites. But you read the book of Psalms, and David was one of the most discouraged men of God in the entire Bible. But who wrote as many songs as him? Mm. Not even Chris Tomlin can top that. Even my dear friend, not my dear friend, but my brother in the Lord, Andre Crouch, or Bill Gaither for that matter, your guy. But we need to encourage ourselves in the Lord.
Amen.
And sometimes you encourage yourself in the Lord by singing.
Yeah.
Singing about the Lord. But then singing to the Lord.
To the Lord.
You see, it starts with singing to the Lord. It starts with singing, about the Lord. But then we can sing to the Lord. Or you can go right into just singing to the Lord. And that will encourage you. The word of the Lord is an encouragement.
Yeah. Yes.
That's why I read it every day. That's why I have devotions every day. It's to encourage us. So when we just sang just now, welcome all of you tuning in. When we just sang right now, we did that as an encouragement.
Yeah.
So whatever you go through in life, you can encourage yourself in the Lord.
Amen.
That's
Amen.
Why Joshua chapter 1, starting with verse 1, all the way down to verse 8, 9, it says that you will be successful and you will make your way successful.
Yes.
That's what the Bible says. You will make your way successful. That's right, you, through the Lord. And one of the ways to be successful and making yourself successful is by encouraging yourself in the Lord.
Amen.
And I know there are times when I get discouraged, I have to encourage myself in the Lord. Pastor Eddie, you ever get discouraged?
Absolutely, yes.
What do you have to do?
Yeah, encourage myself.
Joe?
Sure,
yep.
Do I ever get discouraged?
Yes.
Yes.
And what do you do?
Encourage myself in the Lord.
Right. And that's what you do, right? We're not just, you're not just answering a hypothetical question, right?
No.
Right.
And obviously, Pastor Joni?
Me too.
Encourage
myself in the Lord.
And that's what keeps us going. That's what has kept me going for nearly 50 years in ministry. That's what has kept this church going. Not me, but the Lord. But encouraging ourselves in the Lord, it removes despair, it removes rejection, it removes fear. Frankly, it removes anxiety. You ever deal with anxiety? Anybody? Joe, you ever deal with anxiety? Pastor Eddie?
Yes.
Pastor Joan, you ever deal with it?
Yes.
Folks, you ever deal with anxiety? You ever? I'm not trying to speak it over you. Have you ever? I have, and sometimes I still do. And we all have things that we have to deal with. Discouragement, as we mentioned. Sometimes even depression. But we can encourage ourselves in the Lord. Yep, people are saying yes, of course, of course.
Yes.
It's a no-brainer. It's an oxymoron. It is. But we have the ability to encourage ourselves in the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Pastor Eddie, I know you're going to get going soon. We don't want you to be late for your date with the youth and young adults. So why don't you greet the people and then tell us what you're sharing with the young adults and with the youth.
Yes. Good evening. Good evening. Welcome live to the Sanctuary of Encounter Church. We encourage you to like, comment, and share. God bless you this evening, just believing that God is going to continue to do what he does, which is speak his word. Amen.
Yes.
And tonight with the youth and young adults, we're going to be talking about just stepping out resiliently in faith and walking out, even though things may seem like you're drowning, but he is there to pick us up. So we're going to be talking, you know, how, you know, Paul walked on water and then he completely, you know, turned his eyes away and started to drown and stuff
Peter
you know, started to drown, and immediately as soon as he gazed back his eyes on Jesus, he was able to resiliently finish off the task at hand.
Well, you don't know this, Pastor Eddie, but that's in my notes to share tonight.
Amen.
That's right there in my notes to share tonight.
Peter, not Paul.
You sure it wasn't Mary?
It wasn't Mary.
Wait a minute. There was Peter, Paul, and Mary.
Yeah.
No, I'm just joking. Guess what? I do that often myself. I knew who you meant. Joe's the one who corrected you.
I was helping him.
You know what?
He's helping
Pastor him. Pastor Eddie, I was just going to cover your nakedness.
You
but Joe, you know, had to give you that, you know, that zinger. Right. Joe had to give you that zinger. No,
because I love him.
Because guys, you know, we're family. We're family, you know, and we love each other. We don't use each other, and we don't abuse each other. The remnant of God does not abuse. Some people will use people to get ahead in life. Many people have used me to get ahead in life. They've used me, and they've abused me. But guess what? I encourage myself in the Lord, and I keep going. You know, Pastor Eddie, it's funny. You mentioned the word resilient. That word of the Lord is really, here we are. We're in June, almost halfway through the year.
Yeah.
Almost halfway through the year. And apparently that word is really stuck in your spirit, huh, on resiliency.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the Lord for that. That's encouraging to hear. So, Joey, yeah, Joey, greet the people, would you?
Good evening, church. God bless you. What an evening to just engage and connect and receive. I'm just excited about what God is doing in all of our lives. And I know that he's got something very special in store for
Amen.
Every single one of us. So press in, press forward, and trust the Lord every step of the way.
Yes.
And you're going to see the hand of God open up upon your
Amen.
Life.
Say, Joe, that's good prophetic. Yeah. See, encouraging yourself is also declaring the word of the Lord.
Yeah.
And Joey, you just declared the word of the Lord. Yeah. You did.
Thank you, Lord.
I like your yellow. You look so cute.
Thank you.
Now, Pastor Joni just got a haircut. I guess such. Hey, fact checker, do you see a haircut here? Do you fact checker?
All this cut off.
Do you see a haircut here? She went to the salon the other day. Okay, I almost said saloon. You see, you said Paul,
yeah, I did.
But you meant to say
Peter. Yes.
I almost said saloon. No. So you went to the salon.
I did.
And you got yourself what?
She cut a lot of hair off.
Okay.
But it's just my, you know, it's my natural
It's my natural curl, and my layers are growing in.
Okay. I know as soon as I talk about your hair, these comments are going to light up. Soon as I say something about Pastor Joni's hair, these comments light up. You know what I'm saying? But you know what? You look so cute.
Thank you.
Look so cute. Yes,
thank you.
You look so cute. You look so cute no matter what. You always look so cute. Yes, you do.
Thank you.
So were you done greeting the people? Look, already to talk. No one's saying anything about my hair, about the prostate pills I'm taking. No one's saying anything about my hair. Stop looking. Okay? Sometimes you got to fake it till you make it.
Thank you.
But this is the way I feel right now in my head. show people. See Pastor Eddie. See his bald. See his bald spot. Pastor Eddie has a bald spot on his knee. Pastor Eddie has a bald spot on his knee. Well, I don't mind bald spots on your knees. Okay. Hey, you know who the shortest man in the Bible was? Do you know who the shortest man in the Bible was? Nehemiah. Nehemiah? Nehemiah. All right. They're still talking about your hair. Look, they're still talking about, Pastor Joni this, Pastor Joni that. All right.
Well, Tommy says
you've got hair.
Like, you got hair, period.
I don't know if he's talking about you or me, okay? Hey, Tommy, we quoted you Sunday, no time for games. Remember you said last Wednesday, no time for games? We quoted you on Sunday on that. Anyway, so you greet the people.
I just want to say this about encouraging that, you know, the stresses of life would always try to weigh us down. And, you know, we need to, like, if we can't rely on somebody else to encourage us, we shouldn't rely on somebody else. We need to know.
I mean, we should encourage each other.
Exactly. But if in the event somebody's not going to encourage you, you know, you're the one that's really responsible. So you need to encourage yourself.
Yeah.
And the Lord's given us many facets and many ways to be able to do that. And I mean, there's a whole manual just for us, you know, to encourage ourselves in the Lord. So I'm so grateful that the Lord has provided that for us and that He is an encouraging God. He's a fair God. He's a just God. He's a loving God.
Yes.
But He's also a very encouraging God.
Amen.
So we're grateful for that. And I pray that God meets you right where you're at. That if you need encouragement tonight, hang in there. You're going to be encouraged tonight.
Well, amen. Listen, if you've tuned in to be encouraged tonight, you've tuned into the right broadcast.
The right place, yes.
But, you know, with that said, sometimes the Lord will deliberately, the Lord will deliberately not have people there for you.
Mm.
I know what I'm talking about. He's done it to me.
Mm-hmm.
He's done it to all of us. But sometimes the Lord will deliberately not have anyone there for you. I tried calling so-and-so, or I texted so-and-so, I didn't get back to me, or I sent an email, blah, 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 blah.
They're always there for me.
And they're always there for me. And now when I need them now, hear me, sometimes God will deliberately not have somebody there for you so that you can fully depend on Him.
Right.
And it happens to me, frankly, pretty regularly. Pretty regularly, you know, I on a regular basis get up on a Sunday and encourage people. I on a regular basis on a Wednesday get up and encourage people. I on a daily basis get up and encourage my wife, my kids, my family. But I don't have a lot of people that do that to me. And you don't need a lot of people, you just need the right people.
Right.
But sometimes God will even deliberately withhold people from me so that I fully depend on Him. Hear me, without feeling sorry for myself. Come on now. Come on now, without feeling sorry for myself. Feeling sorry for myself will not allow me to be a success. So I have to encourage myself in the Lord, but sometimes God will withhold people from us so that we can encourage ourselves in the Lord. Okay, so this Sunday is Father's Day. We have brand new Rolex watches, not knockoffs. I was just in Milan. I got all brand new Rolex watches for all the men that come. So tell the men if they come this Sunday, they'll get a brand new Rolex watch. No, we said that on Sunday. We were joking. But we do have gifts for the daddies. We're going to play a video for the daddies. We're going to pray a blessing over the daddies. Again, this Sunday is Father's Day. And Lord willing, I will continue ministering on finding freedom and forgiveness. And that's a key right there.
Yes.
You know, if we don't forgive, our prayers aren't answered.
Yeah.
If we don't forgive, mountains are not moved. If we don't forgive, God cannot give me my heart's desires. You guys know that. You guys know I'm not preaching at you. I'm just reminding us, reminding me of God's word.
Well, we have to do it.
We have to do it, yeah.
We have to do it.
We have to do it. You know, we had a family visit this Sunday, precious family visit this Sunday. And the mother came up to me after service. She said, do you know you have a unique church? Mm-hmm. I was like, yep. Yep. She says, the Holy Spirit's really present in this church. Yep. And then her son said to me, he said, I love the way you minister, how real you are with the people, that you don't speak at them, you speak to them. Mm-hmm. You speak to them. And he said, you're such a fine community to where you allow the people to engage with you. Well, that's what the church is supposed to be about. When I ask a question, we're not supposed to be like mummies and robots, you know? Imagine in school if your teacher asked you a question and you just froze up. You know, your teacher would think, what's wrong with you? Well, the body of Christ has become robotic. In fact, let me tell you something. I'm going to let Pastor Eddie go in a minute. I found out today, listen to these two words. There's a new book coming out by Rick Warren. There's a new book coming out by Rick Warren. Listen to these two words of the title. Somebody comment this. It blew me away. Editing Jesus. Somebody comment that. Editing Jesus. I found out today that Rick Warren is coming out with a new book entitled Editing Jesus. And if you know me, I do not endorse a lot of books. I will when I feel to do so. But Rick Warren is coming out with a new book entitled Editing Jesus. And I cannot wait to get my hands on that. He talks about our culture, how people edit Jesus, how they accept what they want to accept from his word. They accept what they want to accept from his word, but reject what they don't agree with. That's where America is at. This is our cancel culture generation. So Rick Warren has written a new book entitled Editing Jesus. And I tell you, I believe that is prophetic because that's where the church in America is at today. They edit Jesus to make Jesus feel good for them rather than incorporating the whole gospel.
Right.
So that's it for that. This Sunday, Father's Day, we have gifts for the dads, finding freedom in forgiveness, and Rick Warren's book, Editing Jesus. That's going to be a good one. But just what I shared with you already is good stuff. Pastor Eddie, say goodbye to the people, and we'll see you later on.
Bye. I love you.
And you haven't given me a kiss in a long time. Mwah. I love you, buddy. Blessings upon you.
Love you.
All right. Okay, we're going to now submit. We're going to now submit our prayer requests. And thank you guys for tuning in. More of you are tuning in. We love you so much. Yeah, Editing Jesus. Wow. And more of you are tuning in. So right now, let's comment our prayer request.
Yes.
Okay, so let's do that right now. Let's do that right now. Pastor Joni, what are you believing for?
I would like to see infertility end. You know, I know several married couples that are believing God for a baby to get pregnant, and you know, they've tried a lot of different things. They've waited a long time, but they would so desire to have a child. And my heart goes out to them. Amen. And I just really want to see that happen for them. So, and I know that there's many more. So that's my plea that usually is the forefront on a Wednesday night, is just believing for that.
Okay, church, who are you believing for? Well, wait. Joe, who are you believing for?
I'm believing for my friends. I'm also believing for the United States to turn and run back to Jesus.
Amen.
And if the Lord is looking for the church to be first in line, then that's what we need to do.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, here they come. They're coming like a snowball.
Yes.
Rolling down a hill, developing into a huge ball to make a snowman. And here they come.
Yes.
Here they come, Joe.
Yes.
So let's keep them coming.
Yep.
Keep them coming. Let's agree together now. Let's agree together. Let's all participate. Let's all engage and believe by faith that whatever you're commenting will come to pass.
Yes,
in Jesus' name.
Yes, Lord.
Joe's going to pray with fire. Yes. Get ready.
Get ready.
Let's agree together.
Yes.
Let's have the equal fire on your end. Here we go. Go ahead, Joey, baby.
Come on, warriors. Let's pray. Let's agree right now. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you for this is a privilege, Lord, to come before your holy throne with intercession and prayers. And Lord, right now we lift up your leaders, your fivefold ministers, Lord God, those that you've called for this day and hour. Cover them, protect them, anoint them, Lord God. Place a fresh fire upon them in Jesus' name. Use them, Lord God. May every service and every gathering, Lord God, may the fire of your Holy Spirit rest upon them and those that they're ministering to, Father. We thank you, Lord God, for our spiritual father and mother. Continue, Lord God, to use them in a mighty way. Continue to keep them strong, healthy. Continue, Lord God, to bless them with revelation knowledge, Lord God. We know that you have released mysteries into apostle for the church in this day and hour. Continue to pour it into him, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Use him, Lord God, to reach others, Lord, to touch the church, to touch the body of Christ, to touch the lost, to touch the nations of the world. Father, you've called him and raised him up for this day and hour. Father, we thank you for doors that you have opened that he can walk through and deliver the message that you've placed in his heart. We call him blessed coming in and blessed going out. We pray for their children and grandchildren. Cover them, Lord Jesus, by your precious blood. And we declare that no weapon, I want you to agree, that formed against them will prosper in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And now let's pray. Let's pray for the United States of America. Lord, forgive us, Lord God. Forgive the church, we pray, for not walking in forgiveness, to not walking in love and unity as you have called us to do, Lord God. Lord, you said that freely we've received and freely we should give. So Lord God, do a work in your church. Let Encounter Church, this apostolic church that you've raised up, let us be on the forefront, Lord God. Continue, Father God, to use us in a mighty way. We pray, Lord God, that the church would unite, that the church would walk in love, that the church would walk in power, in the Holy Spirit power. For Lord God, then you will see the lost one, Father. We thank you, Lord God. We come together. Knit us together, Lord God, as the body of Christ, where every joint will supply, Lord God, where every church will fulfill the vision that you've given them in Jesus' mighty name. And Father, we pray. We pray for our nation. We pray for our nation to run back to you, to run to your altar, to run to the cross, to cry out, Jesus, it is you that we seek and desire. Father, we pray, Lord God, for an outpouring of your presence, an outpouring of your Holy Spirit upon the United States of America, from coast to coast, from border to border, Father, all 50 states, Lord God. We pray for your kingdom to come and your will to be done in our nation, Father, and we thank you for it. Father, we cry out, one more great revival. Let it come, mighty God. Let it come and let it sweep across our nation and the nations of the world in Jesus' mighty name. And Father, we pray for our governmental authorities, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, for your presence to be strong upon them, Lord God, for you to reach them, Lord God, for them, for their hearts, Lord God, for there to be accountability in our governmental authorities, Lord God, from the White House to our house, Lord God, every governor, our president, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for character and integrity to be, Father God, their witness, Lord God. Father, I pray, Lord God, against false witness. I pray, Lord God, against lies of the enemy in Jesus' name. And I pray, Lord God, that there would be accountability for, Lord God, you are looking at every one of them and every one of us and holding us accountable according to your word. So, Father God, have your way in the United States. Have your way in every leader. Have your way in every every judge, Lord God, from the Supreme Court to the municipal courts in Jesus' mighty name. And now let's pray. Let's pray for Israel, for the nation of Israel. Pray, church. Pray for those hostages that still are out there. Lord God, bring them home, Lord. We know, Lord God, you still are a God that delivers. And we believe, Lord God, for every one of them to come home safely in Jesus Christ's mighty name. Cover the nation of Israel. Lord God, keep them strong, Father God. I pray your hedge of protection over the entire nation, Lord God, over the people, Lord God, over those, Lord God, that are not in Israel, but all across the world. We pray against that spirit of anti-Semitism in the name of Jesus. I want you to curse that spirit of anti-Semitism in Jesus Christ's mighty name. It has to go. We render you, we arrest you on the authority of our Lord Jesus, and we say, Satan, the Lord rebuke you. You spirit of anti-Semitism, go back to the dry places and where you'll wither and die in Jesus' mighty name. And Father God, give Prime Minister Netanyahu, give him great godly wisdom. Give their military leaders, their political and religious leaders, great godly wisdom to lead the people in this turbulent day. And Father, continue to speak to them. Continue to open their hearts up to receive and know that Jesus is their Messiah, that he is their Christ, and he's coming back for them one day in Jesus' mighty name. And now let's pray. Pray for all the nations of the world, all seven continents. Father God, sweep across the nations. We pray for the underground church, that Lord God, that you will give them the strength, Lord God, to persevere in this day and hour. We pray, Lord God, for those that are being persecuted, Lord God. May your grace abound, Lord God, upon them in Jesus' name. Those that have been arrested, those that have been persecuted, those that have had heinous things done to them because they believe and call Jesus their Lord. Father, we pray for them. May there be greater grace upon them. May there be greater divine strength upon them. And Lord God, use them, Lord God. Every missionary, Lord God. Every leader, every believer, Lord God. Set us ablaze to reach out to the lost and dying, to be a witness, Lord God, in this day and hour. And we thank you for the privilege of being part of your kingdom and serving you in Jesus' name. And now let's pray. Let's pray for our firefighters, our police officers, our armed services, Lord, our paramedics, all those first responders that are out there. Father, we lift them up before you. Father, every person in the armed service, Lord God, we pray your covering over them. The blood of Jesus Christ protect them. Those in different countries, Lord God, give them wisdom, Lord God. Give them discernment, we pray. We pray for every police officer. We pray for every firefighter. We pray for every agent, Lord God. We pray for every paramedic, every doctor, every nurse, Lord God. Everyone, Lord God, may your grace abound. May your strength rise up in them in Jesus' mighty name. And we thank God for them. Father, we thank you for them, for everyone. And we speak blessings upon them and their family and their children and grandchildren, that they would walk and live in peace, Lord God, in Jesus' mighty name. And now, let's start praying for these prayer requests. You've been commenting them. You've written them. You're lifting them up verbally in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we come into agreement right now, Father, that you, Lord God, are going to take every request. Every request that's commented, everyone that's written, everyone that's verbally lifted up right now. And Father God, you are a God that answers our prayers. You are the God of the miracle. You are the God of the breakthrough, Father. We believe you, Lord. We stand on your word, and our trust and faith is in you and you alone. So Lord God, we thank you. I want you to stretch your hands. Stretch your hands as a sign of agreement in the mighty name of Jesus. Every request, every prayer request is now being turned around into a praise report in Jesus' mighty name. We thank you for it, Father, in Jesus' name. And now let's pray. Let's pray for Sunday service. Let's pray for our church, our hybrid, all the people. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for this Sunday service. Father's Day, Lord. We will honor you first and foremost, Lord, because you are our heavenly Father. You are the perfect Father. You are the one that loves us and cares for us and blesses us. So we thank you, Father God. We ask, Lord God, that the presence of your Holy Spirit would be so rich this Sunday, Lord God. That lives would be touched, Lord God. That your presence would permeate and separate soul and spirit. That the hearts of people would be changed. That fathers will be blessed. We pray for reconciliation, Father God. We pray, Lord God, for relationships to be renewed and strengthened in Jesus' name. We pray for fathers to step up and take their rightful position to be the leader of their home, to go back and to be there for their children and grandchildren and great-grandchildren in Jesus' mighty name. And right now, let's just finish up by praying for healings and for miracles and salvations. Heavenly Father, we thank you. Every person sick in body, in the name of Jesus, be healed. I want you to take, if there's an infirmity, I want you to speak to it right now and say, I cancel you, you lying devil from hell. Sickness is not of God. I cancel that. I cancel that sickness. I cancel whatever that is. Cancer, heart disease, arthritis. I cancel you on the authority of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Father, we thank you for everyone sick in mind. Lord, as I place my hand upon my head, may you touch every individual that's dealing with mental illnesses right now in Jesus' mighty name. And Father, we thank you, Lord God, that we are in the last of the last days. And we ask, Lord God, place a burden in our hearts for souls. Those five we need when we pray, and we will continue to pray for their souls to be won. Father, thank you, Father God. Use us, Lord God. Use us as you desire to reach out, to touch them, to do whatever it is to woo them and draw them to your cross, Lord God. And we know you are the Lord God that is you are the Lord of the harvest. So we thank you. And now I want you to give the Lord a victorious shout of praise for all the Lord has done. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
Father, we glorify you.
Yes.
Lord, we glorify you in Jesus'
Lord.
Name.
Yes.
We glorify you, Father.
Yes, Father.
For everything Joe prayed for under this heavy anointing, we believe for in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
Now all of these requests that I'm holding in my phone here, every single one, we agree for every single one of your requests.
Yes.
Every
yes.
single one of your requests,
yes.
we believe God
yes.
for.
Yes,
we every single one of your requests that you've requested for others mm-hmm. and that you've requested for yourself.
Thank you, Father.
We believe now. Mountain
yes.
move.
Yes.
Mountain
yes.
move.
Yes.
In Jesus' la tarabaka dando do busan tarababaka in Jesus' name.
Yes, yes.
Wow. Whew. Heavy anointing.
Yes.
You're shaking, Joey. You're shaking.
Thank
you. He's shaking up
yes.
here. That's the anointing of
yes,
God
Lord.
Permeating.
Yes. Yes.
Even now. It's done.
Thank you,
it's
Father.
It's done.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father. It's done. It's done in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Somebody praise the Lord. I mean
Hallelujah.
That. I mean Hallelujah. That. Somebody praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Church, God just heard us. God just heard us. God just heard us. He's not a man that he should lie. That's right. It is done. It is done. Glory be to God forevermore. Glory be to God forevermore. Thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Lord. It is done. Wow. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Daddy. Thank you, Lamb of God. Thank you for the blood that cleanses us of all unrighteousness even now. Thank you, Lord, that the word of the Lord just penetrates, saturates through our hearts, our minds, even our bodies. And thank you, Lord, for the freedom that we still have, that we can worship you publicly. Save the lost, we pray, as Joe prayed. But every one of these requests tonight, Lord, every one of these requests tonight, Lord, are special to you, Lord. They're dear to you. And Lord God, for all the people engaging, each and every one of them, in the name of the Lord Jesus, spirit, soul, and body, thank the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Father. Amen. Thank the Lord. Well, before I get into the word, I want to share with you a word, kind of like as an appetizer. And this was actually my devotion. It was mine and Pastor Joni's devotion from this weekend. And it's Proverbs 14:27. This was mine and Pastor Joni's devotion from this past weekend. And it's Proverbs 14:27. It says, "The fear of the Lord is a fountain of life." Just dwell on that for a moment. The fear of the Lord is a fountain of life. When I reverence God, not be afraid of God, but when I reverence God, when I reverence His holiness, when I reverence His word, when I reverence His house, when I reverence His money, when I reverence His attention, affection, all of the above, that's the fear of the Lord. When I put Him first, far above anything else, far above anyone else, that's the fear of the Lord. The word says the fear of the Lord is a fountain of life. Just think of a fountain. I love fountains. I don't think I've ever shared that with you, but I love fountains. I know I've shared with you I love palm trees. But I love fountains. And the fear of the Lord, when I walk in the fear of the Lord, it's a fountain of life. Life. A fountain of, just think of a big fountain. What's that big fountain in Chicago?
Buckingham
Fountain. One of the first dates, one of the first dates I took Pastor Joni on was to the Buckingham Fountain. Actually, it was part of our date. Part of our date is we went to the Buckingham Fountain on Michigan Avenue, right across the street from Lake Michigan. I'm telling you what, I've said this before. I've not been to every city in America, but I've been to a lot. And Chicago is one of the prettiest cities in the world. I mean, having a lakefront and a row of condos and skyscrapers overlooking this beautiful, gorgeous lake. And then there's Buckingham Fountain. And it turns different colors. Pink and purple and you name it, every color that God ordained and designed and crafted, and all these colors just shoot out of this fountain. Well, just think this verse, Proverbs 14:27, and I just read you the first half. The fear of the Lord is a fountain of life. Just think of that Buckingham Fountain times 5, times 10. Dare I say times 100? Dare I say times 1,000? Dare I say hundo puto do boko santo? Dare I say times 1,000,000? The fear of the Lord is a fountain of life upon you that refreshes you, that protects you, that guards you, that keeps you. Oh, the fear of the Lord. And that's why what Rick Warren is writing in his book, Editing Jesus. So many people have edited Jesus out of their life. So many people have edited the fear of Jesus, the fear of God, the fear of the Lord out of their lives. But those that fear the Lord, truly, those that fear the Lord, the fear of the Lord to you and I is a gushing fountain that just keeps repeating itself. That fountain goes up, comes down, recirculates, goes up, comes down. It keeps going and going and going. Well, your life, the Lord says in Proverbs 14:27, through the wisest man who ever lived, at least under the old covenant, Solomon, that the fear of the Lord is your fountain filled with life. Not a fountain filled with sickness, envy, strife, unforgiveness, disease. No, life. Next time you pass a fountain, think of this verse. But don't wait till you see a fountain. Think of it regularly. Those that fear the Lord. This ain't for everybody. This is not for everybody. It could be. But those that fear the Lord, it's for. The fear of the Lord is a fountain of life. Claim that for yourself. But you can only claim it, just like forgiveness. I can only move the mountain if I forgive. I can only have my heart's desires if I forgive. Mark 11, 22, 23, 24, 25. Well, God will display upon me, upon you, a fountain of life when I put him first, when I reverence him, when I'm more concerned about what he thinks than what other people think, that I'm more concerned about pleasing him than I am about pleasing anybody else. That's the fear of the Lord, fountain of life. Well, there's your appetizer. Did you enjoy it? Did you enjoy it?
Yes.
Okay. Gives us greater motivation to fear the Lord, doesn't it?
Yes.
All right. Well, now the word of the Lord. If you tuned in again tonight to be encouraged, you've tuned in to the right ministry. I want to share with you tonight, just for a little while, I just want to encourage you about how the Lord was always there to rescue us. He's always there to rescue us. He's always there to deliver us from affliction. Deliver us from the snare of the enemy. He's always there to save us. Many of you know the Greek word is soteria, to deliver us, to save us. To save us doesn't just mean to allow us to be born again, although that's part of it. It's the greatest part of it, isn't it? Being born again is the greatest. But that word soteria means to be saved, to be rescued, to be delivered. Yes. So I just want to encourage you tonight with some word of the Lord to remind you that he's here to rescue you, that he has rescued you, that he will continue to rescue you. Yes. All right. I'm going to start in the book of Psalms. In the book of Psalms, chapter 55. I love you guys so much. And thank you again for your blessings and prayer and prayer support, financial support. When I was in Italy, I spoke to Grandma Vella today. I spoke to Sister Vella today. And when she heard my voice, she started to weep. When she called me and she heard my voice, she started to weep. And she said, "Now tell me, Papa, how was your trip to Italy?" And these were my exact words. I said, "Mama, it was the best trip ever." And I said it just like that. I said, "Mama, it was the best trip ever." And she lost it. I kid you not. For the next about 2 minutes, there was sobbing, 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 sobbing in joy in her hearing about my trip to Italy, just in one word, best. In one word, best. And she started to praise the Lord and started to cry and weep and rejoice and pray in tongues and praise the Lord in tongues. See, the fountain of life, the fountain of life. Well, in Psalm 55, verse number 16. Yeah, in a good conversation with Grandma Vella, good conversation with her. And she was just overwhelmed that her spiritual papa and her friend got blessed. And she said, "I was so happy that Jim David got to be with you. I'm so happy that Jim David got to be with you." So she was refreshing, and she got ministered to, and so did I. Anyway, Psalm 55, verse 16. I just want to encourage you, remind you that God has rescued you and will continue to. Because, let's be very, very blunt. So long as we live in this shell, so long as we live in this earthen vessel, so long as we live in this body, we will constantly have to renew our minds. Always. Until the Lord takes us home, until the Lord takes us home and we take on our glorified body, we're going to constantly have to renew our minds, repent of things. It's because of our Adamic nature. That's why we have to crucify the flesh every day. But there's coming a day. Gloria a Dios. Gloria a Dios. Or as they say in Italy, Gloria de Jesu. Gloria de Jesu. There's coming a day that He will return for us, and we shall see Him as He is. In all of His splendor, majesty, and glory, we shall be like Him. And no more devils to cast out. No more mention of the devil ever again. I'll never again have to say, "Satan, the Lord rebuke you." I'll never again have to renew my mind. I'll never have to again ever to say, "I'm sorry." I'll never have to repent again. Why? I'll have that glorified spirit, soul, and body. But until that day, we have to encourage each other.
Yes.
I have to encourage you to go on another day, another week, another month, another year. And as we said earlier, you have to encourage yourself. So tonight, I'm here to fight the fight with you. I can't do it for you, and you can't do it for me, but we can do it with each other. You got me, I've got you. All right? As Sonny and Cher used to sing, "I've got you, babe. I've got you, babe." We have each other. That's what the body does. We stick together.
Yes.
We don't use each other, and we don't abuse each other, but we stick together. Okay, Psalm 55, verse 16. As for me, I will call upon God. As for me, I don't know what He's going to do. I don't know what she's going to do. I don't know what they're going to do. But the psalmist said, As for me, I will call upon God. I will call upon God. You get it? As for me, I will call upon God, and the Lord shall save me. I love it. That fountain of life is upon you. As for me, again, the psalmist is saying there are those that will choose otherwise. So he's saying, listen, I have no control over anybody else's will, but as for me, I will call upon God. I love this. And the Lord shall save me. The Lord shall rescue me. Help me with another word. Comment another word. The Lord will
deliver
me. The Lord will rescue me. Rescue me, save me, deliver me. As for me, answer me. As for me, I will call upon God, and the Lord shall save me. The Lord shall redeem me. The Lord shall keep me. Thank you, guys. Thank you for helping me preach tonight. The Lord will keep me. I like that. I like them all. The Lord will restore and recover me. He will help me. There you go, guys. The Lord will cover me. Yes. You guys are good preachers. Yes.
Protect me.
The Lord will carry me. Oh, I love this.
Yes.
See how we need each other. The Lord will redeem me. The Lord will carry me. Yes. There we go. All right. So as for me, I will call upon the Lord God. Call upon the Lord God. You get it? Call, Lord God. I'm calling upon you. I'm calling upon you. I know you're not deaf, but I've got to show you, God, that I'm calling upon you with all my strength, with all my might, with all my voice. I will call upon you no differently, Lord, that I will bless the Lord, all my soul and all that is within me. So no differently here, Lord, I will call upon you and I will say, Lord, help, rescue, keep me, deliver me. And he went on to say, and the Lord will do it. Bam. The Lord will rescue me. The Lord will keep me. The Lord will watch over me. Thank you, guys. He is an awesome God. You're right. As for me, I will call upon God, and the Lord shall save me. I love verse 17. It gets gooder. It gets gooder. The Lord will keep me. Yes. Verse 17. Evening and morning and at noon. I love this. Some might say morning, noon, and night. Morning, noon, and night. My Bible says evening, morning, and noon. I will pray and cry aloud. Evening, morning, noon. I will cry out loud to you, Lord. I will cry aloud morning, noon, night. I will cry out to you, Lord God. I will pray and I will cry aloud. I will pray and I will cry aloud. Listen to the rest of this verse. Listen to the rest of this verse. Did you see that, Pastor Joni? And he shall hear my voice.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And he shall hear my voice. I want five people to comment that. And he shall hear my voice. When you comment that, you're activating something in your life. You're activating something in your life. Here it is, Psalm 55. Evening, morning, noon, I will pray and cry aloud, and he shall hear my voice. Somebody comment, there you go. There you go, guys. Oh, wow, you guys are on fire. And he shall hear my voice. Whoa, look at you all. You're activating it right now. You're not just, listen to me. You're not just commenting, you're activating.
Yes.
I'll say it again.
Yes.
I'll say it again.
Yes.
You're not just commenting, you're activating. I'll say it one more time. You're not just commenting, you're activating. There you go. Mandolo sandede peke. Wow. Bam, 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 bam. Wow. Wow, 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 wow. As for me, I will call upon God, and the Lord shall save me. Evening, morning, noon, I will cry aloud,
Yes. And
he shall hear my voice. That's verse 17. I already gave you verse 16. That was 17. Now listen to verse number 18. Oh, you guys are on fire. You guys are on fire. Wow. From all over the country and all over the world tonight, they're participating, folks. From all over the country, from all over the world. They're participating tonight, and I love it. I love it. I cannot say every country is engaging, but several are. Praise the Lord. Yes. All right. Psalm 55, verse 18, and that day's coming. I said, that day's coming.
Yes.
Yep. Psalm 55, 18. It gets gooder. It gets gooder. Verse 18. He has redeemed my soul. I love that R word. He has redeemed my soul in peace. Paz. Pace. Peace. He has redeemed my soul. Not from peace. He has redeemed my soul in peace. That's part of that fountain of life. That's part of that fountain of life. Proverbs 14, 27. Remember that? Proverbs 14, 27. The fear of the Lord is the fountain of life. That was your appetizer. That was your antipasto. All right. Verse 18. He has redeemed my soul, my heart, my will, my emotions, my intellect. He has redeemed my soul in peace. Look at this. From the battle that was against me. Mante, pe, se, ke. He has redeemed my soul in peace from the battle that was yes. Past tense, yes. That was against me. Tonight I submit to you, that battle is not against you tonight. That battle was against you.
Yes.
Put it behind you.
Yes.
Put it behind you. Not in front of you. Stop dwelling on it if you have been. That battle was against you. Now listen, we all know there are new battles waiting. We know that. There are fresh battles waiting. But every one that you rise up against, it's going behind you. Listen, I know what I'm talking about. By the grace of God, G-R-A-C-E, G-R-A-C-E. By the grace of God, I know what I'm talking about. Through his grace, he's redeemed me. Through his grace, he's given me peace. And through his grace and his grace alone, not my grace, his grace,
yes.
By his grace, he's given me peace. And I am free from that battle that has risen up against me. Tonight, whatever battle has risen up against you, it's now behind you.
Yes.
Somebody comment, it's now behind me, please. Yes. Please, a few of you comment, it's now behind me, because you're activating. Man, this is exciting. This word of the Lord is exciting, man. Thank you, Lord. And he has redeemed my soul in peace from the battle that was against me. For the battle that was against me. There you go. Oh, you guys, you got it. Again. You're not just commenting. You're activating.
Yes.
You're activating. See, that's an A. That means it's happening. It's not just it's not just logos, spoken word. It's not just something that you've heard. It's something that's being imparted. It's being spoken into your spirit, imparted, illuminated into your spirit. I love it. I love it. And he has redeemed my soul in peace from the battle that was against me. So listen to me very carefully. When the enemy reminds you of a battle you've been through, you remind him, fella, it's over with.
That's right.
Devil, it's right. Behind me.
Yes.
Somebody comment, it's behind me. Somebody comment, it's behind
yes.
Me. If you don't comment it, just say it out loud right there at home, right there on your couch, right there in your bed, right there in your office, right there on your desk, right there on your phone, right there on your tablet, right there on your TV monitor, whatever it is you're using. Say, it is behind. behind me. It's, there you go, it's behind me. It is. It is. Yes. The word says so. We said on Sunday that he watches over his word to perform it.
Yes.
His word does not return empty. Right. His word does not return void. He has redeemed my soul. Psalm 55:18. He has redeemed my soul in peace from the battle that was against me. And then he finishes the verse. He finishes verse 18 by saying, for there are many that came against me. Oh, ay caramba. Ay caramba. Mamma mia. The psalmist said, he ends this by saying, for there are many that came against me. Oh, church, listen. There are many that came against me. I said this earlier, and it's okay. It's okay. It's drawn me closer to the Lord. So don't feel sorry for me. Anything that draws you closer to the Lord, don't feel sorry for me, please. It's drawn me closer to the Lord. But many have used me. I know it, and they know it. I know it, and they know it. Many have used me as a stepping stone to get ahead in life. They didn't get ahead. They think they did. Many have used me. And many have abused me, but I'm still standing. I still have a smile on my face. I may wear glasses these days. And let's see, my hair, well, that's questionable. But one thing I tell you, I'm still standing.
Yes.
Whew! I'm still standing. I am what I am by the grace of God. I am what I am by the grace of God. I'm a trophy of God's grace.
Yes.
I'm a trophy of God's grace. That's why no weapon ever formed against me has ever prospered. Nor will it ever. Right. Why? Because I've learned and still am learning how to embrace his grace. His ability to do in me what I cannot do for myself. And guys, we're in the same company. I'm here to encourage you tonight. Some of you have been used. Some of you have been abused. Well, the psalmist said, he's redeemed your soul. Somebody say, my soul. He's redeemed my soul in peace. Remember, not from peace, in peace. From fear to peace. He's redeemed my soul in peace. From the battle that was against me. The battle that was against me. Guess what? We won. Guess what? We win. Somebody comment, we win. Somebody else comment, we won. Somebody comment, we win. Somebody else comment, we won. Or comment them both. But just speak it out. If you don't comment it, just say it out loud. If you don't make a comment with your fingers, do it with your mouth. Say, I win. We win. It's right here.
Yes.
And he watches over his word to perform it. His word does not return to him empty or void. This is why I love him so much, because God's not fake. He's real and he keeps it real. Yes, he does. So he said, he has redeemed my soul in peace from the battle that was against me. For there were many. Who came against me. Well, you know what? Let me reverse that for this moment. There are also many that have stood with me.
Yes.
There are also many, like David. David had 400 to 600 men. We don't know exactly. David had 400 to 600 men that ran to the cave of Adullam. The cave of Adullam. The cave of refuge. The cave of safety. Now, has anybody ever been in a cave? If you have, just say, I have. Comment, I have. Have you ever been in a cave? If you have, say, comment, I have. If you have. We don't have too many caves in this area, but there are caves in Illinois, especially in southern Illinois. And the closer and the further down you go south, you have? Okay, some of you have. You have? Okay. Are there caves in New York or New Jersey? That I'm not sure about. If there are caves in New York and New Jersey, I've never been to one.
Poconos, it would be in that mountain area.
in the Pocono Mountains, there are caves in Pennsylvania?
If there were,
okay. Oh, yeah, anyway. But I've been to caves in Missouri. I've been to caves in Missouri. And let me tell you something about a cave. Yes? Oh, there are? Okay, good. I've never been to a cave in New York or New Jersey. I'd like to go one day. Anyway, I've been to caves in Missouri. And let me tell you something about caves. They're dark. They're chilly.
Damp.
I was going to say that. Pastor Joni said they're damp. They're chilly. But David ran to the cave of Adullam with 400 to 600 people. Now, you would think that he would have had 40,000 or even 4,000. Yeah, you're right. They can be a little spooky. That's true. They can be a little spooky. You know, bats flying around. They can be a little spooky. But David, isn't it interesting? Yeah, they're full of bats. They can be a little spooky, yep. But David, you would think that the Bible would say that, he ran with 40,000 men and women and children, or 4,000. But 400 to 600 wise people, you know, those that are like the sons of Issachar, who understand the times and the seasons in which they live in. And David ran with his 400 to 600 people to that cave. And in that cave, God rescued them from their enemies. You know, sometimes God wants us to be cave dwellers. Sometimes we need to be cave dwellers. Now, that does not mean we isolate ourselves from each other. Oh, no, 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 no. Because that's contrary to the Word of God. That reminds me of Rick Joyner's book, Editing Jesus. You know, editing God's Word. Some people say, well, I just need to escape from the body of Christ for a season. I just have a season because, after all, the Bible says there's a time and a season for all things. No, that's editing God's Word. But David ran to the cave of Adullam. And he was there for a season. And it was a little spooky, a little damp, and all the other words that you used. But in that cave, God rescued David and his men and his woman, and the women. And God renewed their strength. Listen to me very carefully. And God renewed that strength. Let me tell you something. Encounter Church is like a cave. Come on. Encounter Church is like a cave. I was saying earlier, we had a family visit this Sunday, and they don't even live nearby, but she works in Elgin, and she drives by this church 5 days a week. And she said this Sunday, the Lord had me stop and visit this church this Sunday. And she said, this church has the Holy Spirit. This church is unique, were her words. And she said, I just saw this little church building, she said. I saw this church building and I was drawn by the Holy Spirit. Well, David and his 400 to 600 men ran to a church like ours that has a lower level as well. So it's twice the size if it was just one level, but it doesn't matter. The point is this, is a cave-dwelling church.
Yes.
This is a cave-dwelling church. Where people come to get refreshed, restored, re-energized, renewed. And David, when it was time to leave the cave, they ran out and they destroyed the enemy and they took all their spoils. They took everything. Well, I'm here tonight to encourage you that we fear the Lord. Encounter Church is a church that fears the Lord.
Yes.
Let me tell you something very bluntly. Let me tell you something very bluntly. We can have a lot more people in this church. We could, if I preached a different gospel. That's the truth. We can have a lot more people in this church if I preached a different gospel. I know what I'm talking about. But this is a cave-dwelling church. Pastor Joni said, David ran to the cave of Adullam to flee from the enemy. Yep. But he came out of the cave and he ran to the enemy.
Yes. Yes.
Wow. So let me read these verses to you again, just to refresh you, encourage you. You know, one of the words for wisdom means to repeat, to repeat, to repeat. Let me share these three verses again. And frankly, I had a lot more to share with you. I really did. But you know how it goes on Wednesday nights. Okay. Psalm 55, 16, 17, 18. As for me, I will call upon God, and the Lord shall rescue me, deliver me, keep me, save me, cover me, redeem me, evening, morning, and at noon, evening, morning, and at noon. I will pray, and I will cry aloud. I will cry aloud, and he shall hear my voice. I want you to know that God's not deaf. He hears our voice when we're serious. He hears our voice when we are serious. And the Lord shall hear my voice. He has redeemed my soul in peace from the battle that was against me. For there were many that came against me. Tonight, we have the victory.
Amen.
We have the victory.
Yes.
We have been redeemed. Yes. We are redeemed because the fear of the Lord is a fountain of life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to the Lamb of God. Well, I frankly can't go on, but I feel the Lord wants me to say, Jimmy, you've given them enough, more than enough, because God's more than enough. He's El Shaddai, more than enough. So just chew on this tonight. I know you're right at this moment at 8:12 Central Standard Time in the evening. You're hearing this for the first time at 8:12 evening in the evening, but listen to it again later, maybe at 9 o'clock or tomorrow morning or tomorrow night, because faith comes by hearing and hearing and hearing. And faith develops us in strength in the Lord. And our faith reminds us that the battle has been won. We have the victory in the mighty name of Jesus. I call you blessed. I don't call you messed. I call you blessed. You, and you, and you. And I know in Jesus' name, as we continue to walk in the fear of the Lord, call upon the Lord and cry out to God, you're going to see a tremendous Thursday like you never have.
Yes.
Fabulous Friday, sensational Saturday, and a super Sunday. And those aren't just words falling by the wayside. I'm giving you the word of the Lord, the word of the Lord. So it's sealed now in Jesus' name. I just wish I can be right next to you right now, just giving you a hug. So I hug you in the spirit. I hug you in the spirit, all of you, each and every one of you. And Sunday, we look forward to seeing you in the house. Those of you that live a distance away, our hybrid congregation, can't wait to see you engage. I thank the Lord for your faithfulness as well. I've said this often, you're equally a part of us. Yes, you are. We love you so much. Now we have the opportunity to worship the Lord with our tithing, with our offerings to the glory of the Lord. You can give online if you'd like. You can go to ourencounter.com, to PayPal if you'd like. It's safe and secure. You can give that way. You can put it in the mail. If you're in the area, you can come to the mailbox behind the church. However you do it, if you gave this past Sunday for tonight, however you want to honor the Lord, I love you. But thank the Lord for all that has come in and the way he just keeps on meeting all of our needs, meeting all of your needs according to his riches and glory in Christ Jesus, by Christ Jesus, our Lord. And we give him all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. So, Pastor Joan, you say goodnight to these depressions. It's been wonderful. Joe, I'm sorry, babe. The way you prayed up a storm, having Pastor Eddie back here tonight, ministering to the youth and young adults, it was awesome. Oh, I wanted to tell you, next month, Joe Mano is going to be with us, but it's going to be on a Wednesday night. Joe Mano and my friend Bobby Iannello from Boston, my buddy, the three Italians, Bobby Iannello, Joey Mano, and Jimmy Di Palma, and all of us, because in the kingdom, we're not Italian, we're not black, we're not white, we're not Asian, we're not Hispanic, we're one people in the Lord. But Joe Mano will be with us on a Wednesday night next month. Wow, next month is July?
Yes.
Are you kidding me?
Yes.
Wow. And for all of you graduates, God bless you all. God bless you all. Love you all. But yeah, next month, Joe Mano will be with us. And it'll be on a Wednesday night. I'll give you more information on that. And then in the fall, I'm going to do something special in the fall. But we have time to talk about that. We have time to talk about that. So, Pastor Joni, as you were.
God bless you guys. I love you.
You guys are awesome. I truly mean that. Best in the Midwest or anywhere else. From coast to coast by the power of the Holy Ghost. So Sunday, Father's Day, remember the word of the Lord, finding freedom in forgiveness. Amen. The Lord's doing mighty things. I love you all. And if our arms were long enough, we'd give you one big hug. If our lips were big enough, we'd give you one big holy kiss. Thank you again, guys, for tuning in. And we thank you, Father, for the word that you've spoken tonight. And we thank you, Lord, for all those participating in every which way. We thank you for hearing our prayers tonight. And we thank you for this word that you've given us tonight. These words, Lord, we seal it now. And no weapon formed against us shall prosper. I speak the blood of Jesus over each and every one of you. Good night. Love you so much.